Now we're going to turn to what is the biggest party, the biggest New Year's Eve party in the world. Dick Clark's New Year's Rockin' Eve with Ryan Seacrest 2022 is now just one day away. And joining us again with the inside scoop is the host for the past 17 years, Ryan Seacrest. Ryan, it is always great to have you with us.
Good to see all of you.
You too.
Practicing my...
Now, this year is the 50th anniversary. It will be one of the biggest shows ever. And of course, though, comes as COVID is surging. One of your headliners, LL Cool J, has just had to pull out of the show because he tested positive. But you are still having an incredible lineup of powerhouse performances from all across the country. So tell us, what can we expect to see this year?
Well, we wish LL well. Bummed I can't see him in Times Square, but I hope he's doing okay. You know, with a live big event like this, considering the circumstances, things are always changing, especially in a year like this year. So we've still got a great action-packed several hours of live music, performances, and action. We've got, just before midnight, Journey doing some of their biggest hits, which I'm such a big fan of their music. We've got Avril Lavigne and Travis Barker. We have also got Daddy Yankee performing live in Puerto Rico. And between all of it and all the action in Times Square, we'll do the countdown live in Puerto Rico, live in Times Square, and also live in New Orleans with Billy Porter. Liza Koshy joins me in New York City. So it's always jam-packed and busy no matter what's happening in the world.
I'm from the Bay Area, so, you know, Journey was a big part of my life. When the lights go down in the city, you know, that was the last call song of my youth. But, of course, last year, this is going to be very different this time. Last year, you had the smaller audience. It was just some select essential workers. This year, you are bringing back some crowds, but it's also scaled back. Take us behind the scenes with the challenges in the pandemic and how you're adapting day to day to keep everyone safe but still have a great time.
You know, I was watching some of the footage you were playing back earlier this morning on GMA, and it gave me a thought in that context. And I was speaking with our director, Glenn Weiss, about some of the moves we could make as things evolve with COVID at midnight and after midnight. But we're taking every precaution necessary. We're vaccinated. We're being tested on a regular basis. So we're doing everything we can to pull this off, have a lot of fun, but still be safe with it.
And that is absolutely top of mind. And now, Ryan, this is your 17th year hosting New Year's Eve. And congratulations, because you've signed a new deal to keep hosting for years to come. Lucky us. You make it look so smooth, so easy with everything you do. But I understand that behind the scenes last year, you had a little bit of a hiccup, a delay right before midnight, and J-Lo's performance. That's like the highlight of the night. Tell us what happened.
Well, first of all, she always pulls it off beyond belief, and she did. But believe it or not, leading up to midnight, the show's pretty precise, but between 11:40 and 11:59, it's to the nanosecond precise. And they put my voice into all of Times Square, the last few seconds from ABC into all of Times Square to introduce J-Lo. And at the moment I was leading up to saying, and ladies and gentlemen, right before I said, here's J-Lo, they said, they're not ready. Ooh. And so I started going through my head, what is in my J-Lo almanac? What do I know about her? Rattling off. Well, so I was just coming up with things on the fly. But in that moment, I will have to say, I don't know what it looked like on the outside, but there was a little bit of panic inside.
Wow. Well, you would never have known from watching it. So, of course, 50 years of Rockin' Eve is not the only big anniversary you have coming up, Ryan. You are also celebrating a milestone at American Idol. The 20th season of that show premieres early next year. You have been there since the beginning. So tell us, I think we have some footage from that very first year that we're going to roll here. How is season 20 going? And what stands out to you? No, this is a good thing. Don't block your eyes. But what stands out to you after 20 years on the show? Millions again last
night. So well done. Really good fashion and hair decisions. That looks very, very natural. I really can't look at that. What stands out, first of all, I'm so proud of American Idol. It is such a great franchise here in this country. And what stands out to me every year is how much remarkable talent there is across the country. People, young people who are going to their jobs every single day that really are stars, but they just need that shot. They just need that big break, and that's what we try and do every season.
Ryan, the busiest man in television by far. Thank you so much for joining us. It is always a pleasure having you, and good luck with the big party. The 50th anniversary of Dick Clark's New Year's Rockin' Eve with Ryan Seacrest 2022 airs live from Times Square tomorrow at 8 p.m. Eastern and Pacific on ABC.
Well, hey there, GMA fans. Robin Roberts here. Thanks for checking out our YouTube channel. Lots of great stuff here. So go on, click the subscribe button right over here to get more of awesome videos and content from GMA every day, anytime. We thank you for watching, and we'll see you in the morning on GMA.